welcome to the show Excellence in All Things, being sponsored by Monrovia Doherty Black Alumni Association. This once again is a part of our summer series of Stars Among Us. And today who I have in studio is one of our scholarship recipients from Doherty High School. So without any further ado, I'd like to introduce you to Anthony. And I apologize, Anthony, because I forgot your last name.
Anthony Smith.
I did it! It was good! Awesome!
But I prefer to go by AJ.
You know what? When I have to tell you this. When I had the twins in, I kept saying Anthony, and they were looking at me like, Anthony? Then they said, you mean AJ? I said, I don't know anything about an AJ. on my list, it says Anthony. So that's all that I know. But yeah, that's what they said. And I had wrote down, because I said, I keep forgetting, because I have all these telephone numbers for Monrovia students, as well as Doherty students, as well as Monrovia High School students. And I have all these numbers, but no names. Absolutely.
Yeah.
So then I'm scrolling down today, and I'm thinking, wait a minute, I thought I wrote his name. And then I go, wait a minute, because the reason why I remember your number, because I had a number years ago that started with the first three digits of your number.
Oh,
because
okay.
I love those numbers.
626.
No, not the 626, not the area code.
The 272.
Yes. And so, anyway, that's why I remembered. And so, when I put your name in today, I put Anthony, and I'm thinking, I don't have time to look up the other thing. I said, but somehow Smith is going through my head. So, I wrote it. That's what I put in Smith. But when I went to introduce, I said, I'm not going to call him by the wrong name. He's going to just have to tell me his last name. And I was right.
You were right.
Yay! Anyway. So I digress from what our purpose here. So what were some of the activities and things that you did at school, at Doherty High School?
So at Doherty High School, I was not too involved in the school communities. I tried joining the anime club, but...
The what?
There was an anime club.
What is that?
Anime, as in Japanese animation. So it really just translates to the word animation. But in America, we associate it with only Japanese animation because we have our own. So, anime.
Oh, okay.
Like, you know, like Pokemon.
Oh, okay. See.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay. Because that's like you're speaking a foreign language to me there.
Okay.
Okay. So you were in that club or you weren't?
There was a club for anime that I wanted to join, but they didn't discuss or do any activities. All they did was watch anime all day. So it wasn't really in...
So it was a club to watch?
Yeah, it was just a watching club. So I did not join that club. I was in the jazz band, and I was in theater with Ms. Bartlett.
Oh, okay. Jazz band. What instrument did you play?
Piano.
Oh, you did?
But I'm more fluent in guitar.
Oh, really? Okay. All right.
There was a lot of guitar players in the band. So Mr. Torres was like, yeah, you're not going to play the guitar, bro. I was like, but can I just play to see what you think? And he said, yeah, bring it in. And then I never did it. So I just stuck with the piano.
Oh, so, but you like the guitar better than the piano?
Like is a subjective word. I like piano more. I'm better at guitar.
Okay.
So it comes more naturally to me. But the piano, I enjoy it more.
You should have brought your guitar in.
No, it's okay.
Okay, so what else did you do?
So, I tried to join the poetry club. I was only in that for a short amount of time because, you know, I don't really remember the main reason. There were some things that were pulling me away, different performances, like from theater or whatnot.
Oh, okay.
But it's not like I was doing much. I can't recall why I left.
So, you like writing poetry?
Yes.
Look at
sort of.
Sort of.
I'm a writer and I'm a rapper, so poetry just comes naturally as a fusion.
Oh, okay, that's very interesting. Because I have to tell you this, I used to publish a magazine some years ago. Back the last publication was in 2008.
Okay.
And I'm just that back started a gradual thing in doing publishing the magazine. So I'm pulling from here and there, and getting trying to solicit different writers and to have different articles to put in there. Mm-hmm. So the bells went off. And see, and I have your number too.
Yeah. So you can contact me.
Yes, yes. Okay. So what were the other things that you were involved with in school? With those the other
those were the only things.
Okay. Did you play any sports or anything?
Not a sports guy.
Not a sports guy.
My whole family loves sports. I just don't. I did track when I was younger, but it's too much. I like to run to get somewhere, not just to run.
Run to get somewhere.
Like, I run all over campus. Anytime you see somebody running and rapping, it's most likely me. So most of the people on the campus know who I am just because they've seen me around. But I don't like running on a track.
I don't like running either. I didn't like that. I'm a walker. I like to walk. Hmm. And swim.
And swim.
Yeah, that's what I like to do. Okay, so now did you do any outside volunteering projects or anything like with other organizations or anything like that?
Not during the years I was at DHS. I did when I went to Damien High School, uh-huh, my sophomore year. Mm-hmm. And I did when I went to a performing arts school in Upland.
Well, that's okay. I totally forgot about it. I'm glad you said performing arts. So we're going to backtrack because okay. You said you love to act or perform. So right, that yeah. Performance was the rapping, or that performance was acting, being in a play or...
I like acting. I love rapping. Just being the main center of attention is natural to me.
Oh, okay. All right. So then this is good.
Sort of, yeah.
So now what are some of the things... So were you actually in a play?
When I was at the performing arts school, uh-huh, we had multiple plays throughout. The big one was when we performed at the gala. So that was our final. And the whole school did that regardless of whether you were in theater or not.
Oh,
and we
okay.
all had different parts that the Professor Coleman, mm-hmm, Marcus Coleman, he oversaw everything.
Oh, okay. Now, so when you, with rapping, what did you rap about?
I rap about anything that's ever been animated. So comics, Marvel, DC, Sonic, anything that's anime, animation, cartoons, Disney. Like anything that's ever been animated, ever, Adventure Time. You tell me to watch it and it's done. I actually plan on binging My Little Pony. So, anything.
You plan on doing what?
Binge watching.
Like, oh. You binge watching
a show, My Little Pony.
I love My Little Pony. See, I'm a former kindergarten teacher.
Okay.
Yeah.
So you've dealt with kid shows.
Yeah. So is My Little Pony still around?
I think they make some new ones nowadays, but I'm not going to watch those. Just the original.
Yeah. Now, could you do something now? Well, let me ask this question, because I asked someone, I remember last year, this individual, she did a lot of writing, and then she rapped, and so when I asked her to rap, you know, what she did, it was good, but I'm going to say but because of me, because I wasn't sure about the content, but the content was very strong.
Oh, profane. Or
no,
deep.
No. It was very deep.
Okay.
It was very deep. And it was excellent, actually. And I probably was more in shock that it came from her, because, you know, you get this, you know, you look at a person and then you prejudge what would come out or on how they are, mm-hmm, and so that it just actually blew me away. I go, that is so good. You know, she still haven't given me a copy of it yet. I said, but you, when you do it, email it to yourself or mail it to yourself, so you know that that is your original. You know, that's yours. Right. You know, so I actually would like to hear. Can you do something off the top, or
off the top of my head, or something that I've already written?
Oh, or something you've already written.
I could try to remember something I've written, or I could freestyle. It's gonna take a bit to come back, to have some lyrics come back to me.
Okay, but if you can freestyle, then we can continue to talk, and then when it pops, then you can just start doing it. Because see, I'm telling you this because that's who I am. Because if I forget something, we're going on talking, and then boom, I stop. And then I start saying it, and then that's not what we were even talking about. I said, I told you, you know.
No, I could freestyle right now though. Freestyle is just off the top without writing.
It's just, okay.
Okay, before I freestyle, I always do this. I ask you what things are you into, so that I can make references you would understand.
Oh, okay. Well, what am I into? Education, well-being of children, helping others, and serving.
Oh boy, that's hard. Not in the realm of fiction. Okay, I'm a fiction rapper, so nonfiction, I can do it. It's just gonna take more effort. Okay. It's Barbara. Oh, how do you pronounce your last name?
Golar.
Golar.
The H is silent.
Right. Barbara, they call me Golar. Helping others is blessed. And it came from me from Jesus, so I don't have to digress. From the point that I'm trying to make is, we just got to give spit tins to others to help them and lift them up in education. See, mathematics is logistic and logistics is hard to get to, but if you take all the courses like algebra and geometrics, you'll get it. Statistics and everything that's by that, become better. Ah, that's too hard for me. Oh gosh.
What? Just that was not good. Just a little bit. That was great.
No.
Okay. All right. Well, for me, what that little bit that you did and what you took from what I said, that was good.
If I wrote something on something nonfiction, it would come out 5 times better, I promise you. If I were to rap fiction, Pokemon Let's Go, so they call me Ash. I turn my hat backwards and I'm spending cash. Like Robin, so Teen Titans, you know, I'm Robin, like Majin. Majin, no 21, this Dragon Ball Z, and I get it done. Give me your energy, drop a spirit bomb, because it's full of love like me and you. I pull in this game like I'm Goku. SSJ1, no, SSJ2, SSJ, what's that stand for? Super Saiyan. Super Saiyan, that's a Japanese word, I translated it. I come in this thing and I'm slaying. Okay, I'm done. But that's what I normally rap about. You see how much better that was?
Well, see, you were more excited about that than what I gave you.
But if I wrote something, it would have the same level of excitement, because I would be able to access the right words to prove my point easier.
I get it. But it was still good.
Thank you.
Wow.
What are your talents?
My talents? Well, you know, it's very interesting. I, so you don't flip the, the switch here. Okay, that's good. I like to draw. Ooh. I have a friend that they have an African gift store, Rhythms of the Village in Altadena. And so being around that whole family, they're creative and, you know, all this stuff. And also, even prior to that, when I taught, we had a staff member was a wonderful artist, that she actually brought out the artists and all of the teachers there, things that we didn't think that we could do. And so, actually, as a result of that, I have made some, I worked with paper mache and made mask. I have this great big picture like this that's at the store, and I transformed some masks that were Japanese, but I turned them into, with the paper mache, and I turned them into African masks.
Okay.
Yeah. It's quite interesting. You know, to see the before and see the progression, mm-hmm. that seeing the change. So I was actually shocked at myself, you know, with that. And I also like to, I'm not a writer, but I like putting things together. And I like networking and putting people together. And I just like helping people, and just that's what I do. That's what I like.
I need a networker, so we might have to stay in contact. And you're gonna have to show me your art. You have to show me your art too.
Okay.
Sorry,
okay.
I cut you off.
I was trying to think if I have it on the phone, but I don't. I have it on my old phone, but to see the progression, you see the finished product there at the store in Altadena on Lake.
Okay.
Yeah, it's there. They have two of the pieces there, and then he showed me how to make these masks out of these gourds that with using paper mache. So, yeah. Very and unique. Most of the artwork in there that the owner, Onoche, is the one who did that.
Okay. Yeah.
And I love dancing, except for, you know, injured knee. Right. So I don't, but I still attempt to do it. And I love music. Not today's music.
Not like.
No.
Yeah.
I like real music. What? That you hear the instrument, real instruments, not, you know, whatever they call that thing that they make those.
Mixing board?
Yes. Yeah.
Well, the mixing, it's interesting because I see what you're saying. The mixing board captures the sound and then you just mix it with another.
I do understand that, but you have to also understand, mm-hmm. you know, I don't know the age of your mother, but you have to understand when I was growing up, people were standing out there singing. There's a band behind them, a live band. There's an orchestra behind them, live, real instruments, right. Not somebody. And I understand going into the studio and then mixing and all of that. I get that. I understand that. But I want, you know, that's
the experience in person.
Yes.
I get it.
You know, even when I was teaching, I told my kids, we listen to all different kinds of music, you see. But I mostly played older music. So, because I knew also that those were real instruments, not somebody also mixing. And I know there was some mixing, but so that they can have an ear on listening to, okay, that's a guitar, or what instrument that is pronounced for them. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, so where are you going to school?
I will go to Pasadena City College, sorry, for 2 years, and then transfer to Seattle Pacific University, Lord willing.
So, and what are you going to major in?
Creative writing, English.
Oh, okay. Somebody else is going to be doing that. I don't remember. You know, because I've been interviewing.
Right, all day and week.
So many, and I don't know. And you see, I'm going like this. Where were they sitting? You see, that's why I turn like this. I'm mm-hmm. like, where were they sitting? But, yeah. I'm trying to figure out. Somebody, I don't know, one of those people were.
Okay.
That's what they were doing. Yeah. okay, and so what are you going to do with that?
There's multiple things.
Mm-hmm.
If I get discovered anytime soon and become a rapper, awesome. Backups are, I'm going to be getting into YouTubing, but the major, what I'm using my major for is writing. I'm writing a story. So I plan to create it into a full story that releases as books, releases as manga, Japanese books, and then releases as an anime on the big screen. So that's the big
goal. So you're really into that anime.
Oh, I love, I breathe anime.
Yeah, because I can see it in your face. It's just it's zooping that.
Zooping.
Yeah.
I like that.
So then tell me, you just said something
mm-hmm.
in regards to that you really like the rapping. There's people, I don't know, I actually don't know how that works, but there's people that go on, what do you call that, YouTube,
mm-hmm.
that actually have their own
channel.
And so.
I have a YouTube channel and I rap, but I don't post on it as much as my Instagram, which I should, first off. Second off, it gets little to no views, because unless you have somebody that's supporting you, somebody that you've networked with, like let's say I had Snoop Dogg in my phone. I could just call up Snoop, and then he would network me to all these other people, and it would reach a wider audience, and then those people would tell their people, etc. I don't have that. So starting off, it would take years just to get notices, just to get heard. Because people hear, and they're like, oh, I like this, or maybe they don't. but then they share it, or they don't share it. A lot of people in today's generation, they just hear something, they don't even like it. Like, they'll like it, but they won't physically like it, and that doesn't
do anything. Oh, I get it. You just said it twice. You just said it like twice.
But like, they'll enjoy it, but they won't like comment, it. Or subscribe.
I know. Yeah. When you said that again, I go, Then I get it. So, but however, you know, you said about networking. I know some people.
Okay.
So that could happen. You know, they're not big, but they're in there. So, you know, we'll off air exchange. I mean, I already have your one contact information, but email or whatever, that information that I could, or I'm not sure if I'm using the language right, or you can send me the link. That's the right word.
Right, yeah.
Yeah, okay. Whew, I'm getting it. Because I've been, anyway, that's a whole other subject.
Yeah.
Okay, so then I can send them that link.
Yeah.
Like that. Because actually, I know, oh, there's Jamie, there's Sandy, there's this, Wendy, there's this. Oh, I know four people.
Okay. We'll have to talk about that.
Yeah. Okay. Now, so I wasn't sure if I had to ask this question or not, because I really like the way things go. But because of the fact that you are this fascinating, have multifaceted interests also, what would you, two things, what would you tell your younger self, and what you know now, what would you tell your younger self today?
Many, many things. Can I only say one, or?
No, I just want you to share.
Believe in yourself. Don't worry about what other people say or think.
That's awesome.
Just be yourself. Work harder. Focus more. Don't lose focus. Be consistent. Like, if I was already consistently dropping on YouTube from way back when, I'd probably be more noticed, at least now. So, and don't sell everything you buy once you're done with it. Because there's so many things I regret. Like, there was this one show of this character named Mega Man. And I would watch this show, and then, like, the show, I don't know what happened. The government must have wiped it from existence, but it just doesn't exist. And I was at my friend's house yesterday, and I was like, so you know that Mega Man show? And he's like, yeah. And I was like, I'm not the only human being. Like, I don't have fake memories. And I just, anytime I would get a game or buy something, like just buy something, once I was done with it, I would sell it to get cash back.
Okay. Now I understand what you're saying.
And now I don't have connection to those things anymore.
Oh.
Like that show, like that just doesn't even exist anymore. And you look it up, it's not even on Wikipedia or anything. So, where did it go?
Where'd it go? Well, what kind of, was it?
It was an anime show, but.
Yeah, I know, but what did it, was the content not?
No, it was good, and it wasn't profane or anything. It was a kid's show, but it appealed to teenage audiences also. So it was just an overall good show. There was action, it had a good story, it had all the characters. Mm-hmm. Like, it related, the story, the plot, was derivative of a video game, the Mega Man series.
Mm-hmm.
But the Mega Man series has evolved into Mega Man X, and there was no shows on X except this one. And this one told the story well, and now it just doesn't exist anymore.
Wow.
So. Mm.
That's interesting, and some of the things that you said to tell your younger self, what you know now, are the very same things that adults need to tell themselves.
Yeah.
You know. So now tell me this also. What would you also say to incoming freshmen?
Any incoming freshmen.
Mm-hmm. Into high school.
Don't hang out with people that you know you're not going to like or aren't going to like you. Don't just do it just to do it. It's better to be alone and find out who you are as a person, and then be free to be that whenever and wherever you want with whoever, because then people will see that. They won't see an outer shell and then have to find out your inner by spending months. They'll see your inner out because you will be you.
How old are you?
17.
Wow. When will you be 18?
September 29th.
Wow.
I mean,
very wise.
Thank you.
No, back in my day, they would say, oh, that's an old soul. That's very good. That's very good. Once again, also, you know, for some adults to have that, to, you know, get that in them as well. Because, just because. Wow, that's amazing. Now, I have to ask another question here. That it just went away.
I hate it when that happens.
Oh my goodness, it just went away. Oh, I know what it is now.
Okay.
So you're going to go off to PCC. Mm-hmm. Now, one of the things that that the association really likes, because we're doing lots of revamping on what we're doing. And so one of the things is we're really asking, especially those that are local, is to come back to be able to serve and come back and share your story.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. The other thing is to give you a heads up. This is our first meeting in studio. Now you and I now are going to be connected because right. of other things yeah. now. But the other thing, what I do is want to follow up with you come December-ish to see, you know, when does school start for you?
Early August. It's June. Yeah, it's June. Yeah. Early August.
Okay. So in December, just to come back and to see, okay, how was your first semester in school?
Okay.
You know, then we're going to come back again once you finish so we can do the complete year and keep that update.
Okay.
Okay. The other thing is what's going to do with all the scholarship recipients, we're going to compile it's not that, the one with the movie, a DVD
mm-hmm.
That is actually going to be shown in the gala in November. And so also asking, you're probably going to be getting a letter or some kind of notification when that is, because they will like all of those scholarship recipients to come back.
Okay.
To, you know, to be a part of that. Okay? Does that...
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Okay. So we're good on us staying in contact with our other things, separate from
the scholarship. Yeah.
Okay. All right. Sounds good. Is there anything else you would like to say or anything?
I go by Key, as in lock, Force, like Star Wars, and the number 7. Or would that be backwards? If I'm facing Key, Force, 7. And that's what I'm on all social media, if you wanted to find me. I don't know why you would.
Oh, no, you can't say that. Because we just talked about with the rapping
self-esteem and all that stuff. If you want to find me to hear the hottest bars.
Okay, I want you to take a look at that camera okay. right there.
Find me at Key47 on all social media if you want to hear flame. Just pure fire. Oh, and a very weird person. That's me. Weird is not a negative thing.
I know, because weird is good.
Indeed.
Yeah. Because that quote, norm, whatever that...
Yeah, that's not even a thing.
Whatever that is.
Everybody's weird in some sort of way.
Like. Yeah, because, how do I say, you know, when we stay inside of this box or our comfort zone, that's, we actually lose out, we miss out, because, you know, there's a lot of other stuff outside of there. Because of not venturing out. You don't even know what your talents are, you know. And the thing is also is that, you know, God gives every single one of us different talents.
Amen.
However, they're not for us to hold on to. They're for us to share. You see?
I know.
So now I just got confused because you added all that other stuff in there. I want you to look in the camera again and just give, I don't know how to say how to find you. Like my email is quality care. So to find you, you look up
the @ key 47.
Okay, there you go. See, and everybody else probably got that, right. But it's these old ears.
It's okay. It's okay. I talk a
did
lot, so
get it.
Yeah.
So it got lost for me. So that's why I said that. Okay. Well, and our time is up.
Okay.
This went by really fast.
Yeah.
So you will be coming back, and you and I will be in contact. You know, we might even be connected at the hip, you know, with different things, which I'm really excited about that for you. I really am. This is, yeah. And then if you write, because, oh, you know, never mind. See, my head is spinning. Exactly. So on that note with the spin, thank you so much. And we'll see you next time. And go out and be a blessing to someone.